You know, when people are happy, they sit there, man, I wish life could be like this all the time. And they know it's not going to be. They know around the corner, a problem's coming.
Migraine's coming, something's coming.
Something's coming, whether it's physical, emotional, something's coming. Just to know that there's nothing problematic coming. You know, one of my favorite places mentioned in paradise is this guy who makes it to paradise, Surat al-Safat. He makes it to paradise, and he notices his friends sitting there, and they're all just, hey man, you made it too, and they're kind of congratulating each other.
So you'll be having those talks?
Yeah, you're like, oh my God, you're from there, and we're just getting to know each other all over again. I remember you. And then he wonders, what happened to my best friend? I don't see him here. So he, from way back in the day, back in this world, he remembers his one friend missing from this group. And he goes, would you like to know what happened to him? And nobody else volunteers. But he wishes to see his old friend. So imagine this, in Jannah, Allah opens a window so he can see his friend in hell. Okay, so this is a scene described in the 37th surah. So he looks at the guy burning in hellfire, his best friend.
You get to see this now.
You get to see this from Jannah. Because in Jannah you get anything you want, right? So he wanted to see his friend. Wish granted. You get a view into hellfire and you see your friend burning there. And he says, لَقَدْ كِتَّ تُرْدِينَ. You almost made me fall off the cliff too, man. He looks at his friend, doesn't say, you okay, can I pull you out? He doesn't say that. He said, man, you almost took me to the party with you.
That was the guy trying to take him to the nightclub.
That's correct. He goes, you made me, almost got me. You're the one who used to make fun of my religion. You used to say you're too extreme. What do you mean we're going to go back to paradise? Or there's going to be a hellfire? You're the one who used to crack jokes with me about religion. You're that guy. And then, now imagine this guy who's in Jannah, looking at this and saying, oh, thank God I didn't listen to you. Because for a second there I was thinking about it. Right? So he, now the window's closed. But this guy has just seen hellfire. Do you think he's shocked and horrified? He would be. Even though he's in Jannah, he just saw hellfire. So he comes back into Jannah, and it's like he just got here for the first time. The words in the Qur'an are amazing. أَفَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَيِّتِينَ. Are we not going to die anymore? Really? But wait, he already knew that. He's in Jannah. But when he saw a glimpse of hellfire, the most beautiful thing he could appreciate about Jannah, first and foremost, like it's a reintroduction to Jannah, what was the first thing he says? We're not going to die anymore. Except that first death we already tasted. You know? And that's, then the second thing he appreciates, well, I want you to imagine what this is. The second thing he says that he loves about Jannah. Now imagine, trees, mansions, friends, waterfall, all the food you want, amazing things around him. And what's the number two thing? First thing, we're not going to die anymore. What's the number two thing he says? This is the most amazing thing ever. Number two reason, we're not going to be tortured. There's no more pain. That's the second thing he appreciates. Why? Because he just saw what pain looks like. SubhanAllah.